and get in a hurry when they're going to complete what they started. Because they think prayer is just action. Prayer is more than just action. Prayer is a sense of communicating. As you communicate with God, you ask. That's a part of action, is communicating. But just because you ask, it ain't over. You got to continue in the faith and continue to praise God and worship God until you get your results. Say manifestation. See, you don't ask if something, I've got a word, and you out here crying because you got a prophecy that came to pass. But your prophecy ain't came to pass because you ain't completed your prayer. You don't stop praising and worshiping and start looking at God and start looking at you and have forgotten your state. Because you got to be in position for God to move.
Amen.
You got to know, I got to seek him. I got to praise him. You in trouble. You in hurt. You in pain. And you around here looking mad and sad instead of praising and worshiping God and glorifying God until you get an answer. When you get an answer, you still got to wait on the results.
Amen.
Say hallelujah to Jesus.
Hallelujah.
He can tell you it's alright, but you still waiting on alright to show up. You still waiting on your money stuff to flow. You still waiting for change to manifest. And it said, when you pray, believe that you already received it.
Amen.
Say hallelujah, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
So that means that's an attitude. That's a positive attitude. Because I pray, and you believe you already received. So that's praise and worship.
Amen.
That's glorifying God. Still in the storm, still in the situation, but I'm praising and glorifying God like I've already received it.
Amen.
You can't tell I'm going through. You can't tell I got problems. You can't.
Amen.
a bathroom going to the Holy Ghost. They had to bring themselves and their sins had to be washed off before they got to the Holy Ghost. So I got to clean up before I go to talk to God.
Hallelujah.
And I can't even talk to God. It ain't cleaned up. Because the word declares that no one can come to him before they first know who he is.
Yes.
So I can say all I want to, and I'm not clean. I'm not where he at.
Hallelujah.
Because I'm not clean. I got to clean up. Lord, forgive me for what I've done wrong. Forgive me for what I said. Forgive me for my God. Forgive me. See, it's a process I got to clean up from before I even go in the back. You can't come in when you paid up. You can't just walk in my credit house because you don't want. and they listen to the word, but they still outside because they ain't called their name yet. Oh. And they trying to do what these other saints done got in. They want to think one less thing happened because you ain't got in. Y'all ain't gonna talk to me. Y'all look at me like, why you having so much trouble? You ain't got in. No one comes to the Father unless he draw them. Stop thinking you can come when you want to, and shout when you want to, and praise when you want to, and when you need something, you can come to church and God will give it to you. Oh, I'm gonna try to some of you.
God,
but you still look for a move of God, but you have not the love to show. tell me what's missing. You keep that cake in there long you want it. You'll burn it up because it'll never rise up. Because it got no yeast in it. It got no love in it. You can keep on praying and keep on crying about yourself and crying about what they're doing to you and crying about how they're treating you. It'll never rise up because it has no love in it. It has selfishness in it. You can talk about your money and talk about what all you want to get. And God, if you bless me with this, God said, I can't give it to you because you have no yeast. You have no sharing in your heart. You have no love in your heart. So when you get something, you're just going to be selfish. So if you wonder what you miss, it ain't anointing. Oh, you're so anointed. You're so powerful. It's the love. If you wonder what you're missing, you can tell what you're missing when somebody can aggravate you so fast and make you so upset and you have no compassion of this situation.
Glory to Jesus. Thank you, God. Hallelujah.
And you run away, your life won't change. I know you did me wrong. I know you treated me wrong. But let me look at it from your point of view. And it's because I got a love for you that passed me.
Amen.
And even though you do what's best for you, and stuff, even though it hurt me, do what's best for you. Because I love you, and I don't want you to live in a way that displeases to yourself. And if you can't be happy with me, Lord, and you don't be with somebody else, I'm all right with you because I love you. I can't sit with you and if you're aggravated and frustrated. I can't be with you because every time you see me, you know that I love you. I can't stand to see you like that. There's a difference in godly love and man's love.
Come on, Holy Ghost.
See, worldly love can tell you I love you, mistreat you, see you unhappy, and they stun you. But God love can't stand to see you. God can't stand to see you in your shit that you in.
Yes.
You think God enjoying you being unhappy and not getting what your God is grieving the Holy Ghost. That you're not living the life that God has set before you. He's not pleased with where you live. But because he gave you your own will, he don't override your will. If you don't turn the way he wants you to go, he don't force you to come. Somebody said he's only love because that's how much you love him, and he don't control you. If God is so in love, why I'm going through this? Because he don't control you. If you would listen to God, you wouldn't be going through it. But because you want to do it your way and do it what you want to do, because you fell in love with who you want to fall in love with. Because how can you fall in love with somebody who ain't got no love? You ain't know what love is. You've never experienced love in your life. You haven't had nobody ever really showed you some love. So you thought what you seen was love when you never can identify with love, because the only love you can identify is Jesus. Oh, love is, how can you control your life and you ain't never control? See, that's why you should have gotten to know Jesus before you got to know anybody. Then you could have detected what love was. Love is not going out for a fancy dinner. What's going on with him? Love is not when you buy me and get my hair done. That's money.
Amen.
Money is the answer to all things.
Amen.
Now the words are worldly things.
Amen.
But love can come with a cool glass of water.
Amen.
On a sunny day.
Amen.
And you'll get that water and hearts will begin to come out your eyes. Today. shoulder. Always about what you can't get, what you give him. I heard a song one time. Nothing from nothing, leave nothing. Y'all like saying that. See, when you got one eyes, when you don't only see yourself, you can't see what's around you. They said if God is where we're blind your eyes. So you can't see. And most of the time you can't see because the devil will blind your eyes. And the way he blind your eyes to the mirror when you look at you, what you give it. What you giving of your love. But what you call of is a love. Because it's got to be paid back. Love don't have to be paid back.
Come on, Holy Ghost.
Oh, y'all ain't gonna talk to me. Oh, let me, what's in him? Must be some love trying to come up here. It's a little hole, oh Lord, if you can get through him. I see the love trying to come in the spiritual realm. I see a little hole. I said, love, if you can make it through that little hole. Because there ain't much up in here, but you can make it in it. You can turn this thing around. Because you want God to do something for you. But you won't do nothing for him. To show your love for him. It's called sacrifice. Because I know your love for me. Yes. And if I don't wait on you, the devil gonna trick me. Yes. If I don't wait on you, I'm gonna find myself in a situation that I don't wanna be in. So in my suffering, I know you love me, and no good thing when you were home for me because I love you.
Yes.
So in my suffering, I'm going to give you praise and I'm going to keep seeking you.
Yes.
I'm going to keep seeking you in my suffering because I know you love me and you want to speak to me. I'm not seeking you because I need you to speak to me. I'm seeking you because I know you're trying to speak to me because you love me. I know you want me to lie to me and give you praise because you love me. You don't want me to keep suffering this and going through this. But God, so I got to lie myself up trying to seek you because I know you're looking for me. Because you ain't seen it. Because you ain't completed your prayer. So immaturely you have received the word that you shouldn't have got. But because God loved you, he gave you to show you that you can't handle it. Because when he gave you the word, you didn't draw toward him. You kept doing what you was doing. So God said to you, it ain't my fault. It's your fault. Because I gave you the word what you asked me for, but you kept on the path you was going. You didn't turn from your wicked ways. You didn't turn from your sin. You didn't turn from the other place. You kept going where you was going. But yet you want to blame me. You want to blame me for when I give you what you need to cause you to go the right way. But you still refuse to go the way where all your blessings at. Oh God. But you want to blame me. You want to keep your attitude and your personality and do it the way you want to do it. But yet you want to blame me. Oh God. I heard the Holy Ghost tell me, say, change has come over me.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Oh Lord God. See, when you don't know what to do, you gotta seek God to know what to do. You can't just do stuff just to do it. When you never need and you need a bill paid, you can't just do it the way you want to do it. You gotta seek God to give you the money to take care of. You can't just do stuff because you're in a need when you know God loves. See, I'm going to the one that loves me. I'm not going to the one that's going to trick me.
Amen.
I'm going to God.
Amen.
I'm going to seek God because he said he will be found.
Yes.
I'm going to knock on the door. He will answer.
Yes.
And I'm going to keep knocking. I'm going to keep knocking. I'm going to keep knocking.
Glory to Jesus.
Come on, Holy Ghost.